And just go to the bottom of the ramp and then I'll pick you up from there. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Okay, but don't just walk from here, just walk into the... Are you going to... Okay, whenever you like. Yep. Okay.
Which button are you going to press?
The Sims.
Where's the Sims?
Closed doors.
Okay, yeah.
What do you want me to do when?
I don't know, I didn't see what happened first time. Right?
All I do is just press the button and switch the thing on. There we are.
Okay, you're so sorry for. Imagine Goblin's safe music going.
Was that Peter Sellers thing all right in the night, wasn't it? Had that scene in the lift.
Yes, that's right. Yes. Grinning inanely.
Okay,
push, you want
the press the button, yeah, and we'll go.
Swine furiously from that side, keep it coming, yeah.
Okay, as you did, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, press it again.
Warriors, I press the down button as we're shouting as to what will happen. Thank you.
Ring off we go.
Close the engine.
All quiet.
Okay. Further out of shot then. Okay, yeah. Well, your shadow's in shot. It doesn't matter, does it, actually?
No,
that's quite nice.
Yeah.
Okay.
Wish I walked you to where
exactly where you were,
down.
Yeah.
Just behind me, through these heavy steel doors, lie the quarters for the Prime Minister and the entire war cabinet. There are map rooms, a cabinet room, and even a...
Peter, just out. That's it.
Yeah.
Okay. Right, whenever you're ready.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just behind me, through these heavy steel doors, lie the quarters for the Prime Minister and the entire War Cabinet. There are map rooms, a cabinet room, and a vault for the keeping of government papers. There's also a half-mile-long road, along which there are offices for every government department. In the event of a nuclear war, this would have become the nation's capital. Just through these steel doors behind me lie the...
Wait, mine. Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Can you open it?
Just behind me, through these heavy steel doors, lie the quarters for the Prime Minister and the entire War Cabinet. There are map rooms, a cabinet room, and even a document. Right.
I'm on whenever you're ready.
Just behind me, through these heavy steel doors, lie the quarters for the Prime Minister and the...
Just to... So, as you face your nearest edge to your file. Okay. Yep.
Just behind me, through these heavy steel doors, lie the quarters of the Prime Minister and the entire War Cabinet. There are map rooms, a cabinet room, and even a vault for the keeping of government papers. There's also a half-mile-long road, along which there are offices for every government department. In the event of a nuclear war, this would have become the nation's capital.
Try and do a little bit more conviction, but that's textually right.
These sound good takes. There's more ground house, perhaps.
Okay.
Just go further in the corner, nearest corner to you.
To here, yeah.
This is just down here. Okay, whenever you like.
Yeah. I'm trying to walk and talk at the same time.
Just behind me, through these heavy steel doors, lie the quarters for the Prime Minister and the entire War Cabinet. There are map rooms, a cabinet room, and a vault for the keeping of government papers. There's also a half mile or so long road, along which there are departments. Right.
Whenever you like. That's what he thinks of your boost again.
What?
Go on.
Just behind me, through these heavy steel doors, lie the quarters for the Prime Minister and the entire War Cabinet. There are map rooms, a cabinet room, and a vault for the keeping of government papers. There's also a half-mile-long road, along which there are offices for every government department. In the event of a nuclear war, this would have become the nation's capital.
One more time. I'll do that. I'll do it one more time.
Just have a shot, maybe. Yeah. Okay, that's fine. Yeah. If you actually want to peer from. Okay, maybe like.
Just behind me, through these heavy steel doors, lie the quarters for the Prime Minister and the entire War Cabinet. There are map rooms, a cabinet room, and a vault for the keeping of government documents. There's also a half mile or so long road, along which there are offices for every government department. In the event of a nuclear war, this would have become the nation's capital.
Okay.
Happy?
Yeah, let's do that first. because then I'm going to try.
Yes, it's the real one will need something saying that.
Next year.
Next year, it may be up for sale.
Out of it because there's another nice shadow there. Okay, from there.
Okay. Try that again.
Walk straight out, right out of shot.
Yeah. Try again.
Start out of shot. Okay.
Made a nice bang to see this little resonance.
That is sort of thud.
hear that clatter out of there.
Yes, indeed.
Quiet, please, chaps.
If we have him walk all the way up to my place, we can almost just let him up.
Well, yeah, but I mean, what, in wide shot?
Yeah, no.
Well, I can pull back, see?
Pull back as he comes
back.
Yeah,
sure.
Are we ready?
Yeah, okay.
Okay, Peter.
Yeah, not going to be able to work, okay, right.
Okay.
To start...
to start with, how big is this underground complex? How many miles of tunnels are there here?
Well, the whole site is 36 acres underground on this site, the naval stores site here. And there are tunnels which the length of the site is about 3/4 of a mile long. And there are tunnels running in all directions. And out of that lot, there are a total of somewhere in the region of 25 miles of tunnels.
So what's the history of this site? I mean, why and how did such a complex tunneling system be developed?
Well, the site was originally built as a quarry. And it has been a quarry for many hundreds of years, since before the time of Isambard Kingdom Brunel, who built the box tunnel adjacent to here. We've had the Ministry of Defence, the Navy, have been in here since the 1950s when they took it over after the war, when it had been used as an aircraft factory by the Bristol Aircraft Corporation. And we've been in here since then. We used it as a store for the electrical and mechanical components for ships in the Navy.
So why was it shut down? Why aren't you here anymore?
The reason we've moved out is because there is no longer the justification for maintaining such an expensive underground storehouse. The difficulties that we ran into in meeting modern health and safety standards and modern fire standards in this environment forced us really to relook at it, and from that we've reorganized our stores into other locations.
How many people worked here, firstly during the war and then in the period since then?
During the war, I understand there were somewhere in the region of 12,000 working down here, and largely living down here as well in the whole of the quarry complex. But in this, the naval stores complex, which is was initially this site and Hartham and Monk's Park, which are the three store sites, those we employed somewhere in the region of 5,000 at their peak. This was in the 1970s, and it carried on at that level and then slowly dwindled down until the 90s.
And what's going to happen to the site now?
We're looking for someone to take over the site. Principally, we're intending to sell the site, but we're hoping to have someone buy the site with the intention of using the surface and probably not using the underground at all.
Well, as far as the underground goes, do you think there are any potential buyers? It's not really very
There is no attraction unless there is a quarrying company who could use part of it for reopening quarrying away from this site. This site is worked out as a quarry, but there are other areas adjacent to it which still could be quarried.
Okay, thanks very much. Thank you.
Let's see how far we go,
aren't
we?
Yes.
Okay. I think, you know, what you were saying about the theory behind it, I mean, it does seem completely impractical.
Yes, it's in hindsight, perhaps, but it was a gradual development to protect himself from being done. And this is the way of working at that time. And this was the sort of almost the ultimate in stores depot, you know, for its time.
Okay, so if, can you go over that side? I'm trying to avoid my light. So.
Oh, right.
Okay, that's right. In the same sort of order as you were. Is that the same order you were walking towards?
Yeah, well, that's what I was saying. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. No, so you were saying about how big this is compared to other ones.
Well, it is. I mean, it's the it was the biggest single store we had, and it was. No.
Just show the torches.
Okay, come towards me now then.
Thank you.
Just yeah, doing it much,
actually. Let's go forward. I think that's rather more than a torch, isn't it?
Just like that.
Starts, I'm in deep shit.
Yes! You won't be half as surprised as I will be. Huge.
Whenever you like, Peter.
Yep, okay.
Right.
do a static shot. Yeah, but I'll do a static shot. But yes.
terribly.
Sorry.
Thank you.
plenty of them.
Measuring of the in order to there must be a steam pipe around here somewhere.
We should have done all of those, shouldn't we? Just his head going past.
Yeah.
Can I do that? You want to just
have a small part.
Go on then.
it's not what I called you. Why do people raise them? They never have a separation.
Second Avenue, did it? Did we do? I think we did second.
You walked down here.
Did we?
Yes, first time that you put it on the shoulder and walked down.
Was it? No, it's all the. You walked on the left right. Just mind your shadow. Go back a bit. Go up to where the door is up there. Past Mike, light. Okay, now walk past.
So you've got a plane as well?
Yeah, I will have. Go on. Oh no, I don't see you. You're going to have to come further forward then.
Do we still have a
mine? Get back a bit out of shot because I'm just shadow. Okay, right, go on. No, I still don't see you. You're not
off the right It's too sad. Run through the shot.
It's like 5 Go to Smuggler's Rock, isn't it? There was one section.
Oh, that was?
Yeah, where it's in their park. It was very narrow. On the other ground somewhere.
Yeah, it was secretly nice.
Sure it was.
Is it up where... Ah, I think I know where
it is.
Yeah, it's probably just up the road from the lift, where it goes through...
No, you're not actually in Burlington.
Yeah.
think we don't have anybody in it now. No. We'll do that one.
Try one sec.
I think it makes my impression.
I'm going to do them as if you can use them straight off the time. I'm also going to do a wide shot, so if you need to, you can always do it and grab it, so you can always get more of the picture in it, you know what I mean, and lose the edges. Yes.
Yes. Can you get closer to it as well, do you, apart from one wider?
How do you mean?
Closer up, further down the corridor, as in.
Oh, yeah, I think they were back up to you. There is major stuff, but the only stuff they can call to the find is this. Some wartime stuff, which was only the erection of wooden huts, and it wasn't the council being built.
And all this is just here, it's on the floor.
And the catalog, yeah. I think it just started the catalog now.
Yeah, yeah. This is all classified, isn't it?
I'm sure, I don't think they're probably.
A rem, the deep area, I'm not sure.
Well, why? That's.
I remember checking that
government. Out. In fact, it looks like deep area, doesn't it? So that was part of the. That's now become. I don't think this city tower is not.
No, it could be anywhere, couldn't it?
There's moving blocks around. But the amount of cabling in that, in those main road shots is quite striking. Mm-hmm. This doesn't look like YHQ, it looks like quarrying towns.
What's his name? Tom Doherty said that they extended. Sorry, they didn't extend, they deepened the floor. But these machines were used by the War Office, but only the War Office. During the war, I think. But this was actually, which it was on the site, so it's got to be a post-war country. But all these were in the same fire, which was 1957.
Why did they go bust?
Same as I do, that's different.
Oh, it is, isn't it? I'm not sure.
synthetic fact of life. If you look at the sign, there's actually a sign on that. You see, it's pointing to the...
Oh, here?
Yes.
Can you make myself off for this?
It's wonderful. I never heard it at all.
Well, what would you do?
Never heard it.
But then the hope is happening. Oh, because the whole thing would be
reversed.
The corners
curve up. Well, it's okay if it doesn't actually show, do you know? Certainly cut all those together, can't I? Where is it?
Devices, which is 50 miles away.
It's not still there, presumably.
No.
That's all. Makes it a bit more interesting. I've done half a dozen shots. I mean, yeah.
Right. Were you sort of happy to...
Okay, yeah.
Have it all.
Okay. If you're happy, John, I was going to... Just to start off, to say how long were you working down in the... in the quarry, in Spring Quarry, and what were you doing down there?
Well, when I first went down there, it was in 1957, and I worked there right through for 4 years, which brought us to 61. And the job we were doing there, and then We were erecting tanks for fuel storage, which was diesel, which was to help to run the generators in the boiler house, to run the whole quarry.
Could I just say, it might be better if you put the map down, because you're tending to look at the map rather than at me. But you'll have to look at me, I'm afraid.
Okay.
If that's...
okay. Yeah, fair enough.
Could I ask you that question again, then?
Yeah, sure. Well, when I first went down there, into the quarry down there, it was 1957. And I was employed there right through to 1961. And the job we were actually doing down there, we were contracted from the main contractors to erect tanks for fuel storage. And the fuel was diesel. And that was to run the generators and the heating system through the quarry when it was needed. Also, we had to erect tanks in another area for to store the fresh water supply, which was then pumped through with Simpson pumped through to purifiers, and it came back through on a recycle system.
So what was all this designed for, the purifying system, the air cleaning system? What was it designed for, and how long was it meant to last?
Well, it was designed really to last approximately a 12-month, I believe, so that the people living under there would be there for a 12-month without coming up to the surface, without having to come to the surface. So in actual fact, they could live there in safety with the water supply and the generators running everything. They would be safe from anything from the surface.
And what...
What
were all these facilities designed for, the air purification, the water purification, and how long were they meant to last for?
Well, they were designed that people would have a good supply of fresh water for all the uses that you would need to live. And it was in order so they could stay there for 12 months underground without coming to the surface.
Did you know when you were working there what this place was designed for?
Yes, we did. I think it was common knowledge locally. It was there to protect the brains of the country, if you like to put it that way. In case there was a bombing or any radioactive fallouts and what have you, then they would be safe underground. And that was the general knowledge at that particular time, locally.
Just thinking about some of the features there then, there was a bakery, there was a laundry, there was a big canteen. What did they look like, those rooms?
Well, back then, you would have the bakery, the sort of plant that was in there, was a large dough mixing machinery, large kilns for baking, and all the things you would normally get in a bakery or in a small bakery shop or something like that, but in a larger scale. The laundry would be like any other laundry in them days, with the big washing machines and what have you at that particular time. And they had their own drying machines and everything in there.
And you mentioned the telephone exchange. How big was the telephone exchange there?
Well, it was quite a large telephone exchange they had there, because they had to lower the ground to get all the switch gear in. It was quite a size, it was in two parts. And I can always remember it, because for a quarry were rough sort of ground. They made a good job of the floors. They had one black and white marley tile squares on it, and the other part had black and white squares on it. And it looked very, very nice, you know. You wouldn't expect to see that sort of flooring underground.
So was that just in the telephone exchange or all round?
Just in the telephone exchange. The rest of the flooring was on a sort of concrete sort of base stuff, you know, finished in a dark colour. That was the general run out.
And you also had a look at some of the living accommodation, the sleeping quarters. What were they like?
Well, at that particular time, when I seen them getting sort of wrecked, I'd never seen a finished product, but they were in a skilling sort of thing, like studded sort of partition work was going up. And I believe they were supposed to be in like two-bedroom chalets or three-bedroom chalets, something to that idea. But as I say, I never seen a finished product. They were still working on that when I finished there.
There was also a pub down there, you were saying. Can you describe what that was like, what it was called, what it looked like?
Well, that was along one of the sort of side roads. That was you sort of walked in off the road into it sort of thing, and the framework was there with a frontage without any windows in it, right? And you could, and the area was sort of getting planned in the inside, and the name was the Rose and Crown. So that's what they called it. So how they were going to get their beer down there, I wouldn't know. I mean, that's something I wouldn't know. They were all in cans, probably.
But presumably they would have had enough beer there for a year.
Oh, I think so, yeah. Everything else here, I should imagine they would make sure there was enough of all that, plenty of whiskey and what have you.
So what did the pub look like? Can you describe what it looked like?
Well, to me it was like walking along a main street, and there was a big shop with big windows in it, like you're looking at a furniture shop or something like that. It was similar to that, but there's no windows in it, like, but it was going to be like that. It's like you'd walk in off the main road in the big cities into a big cafe. That sort of thing, and the bar would be behind, like, you know. That's what it looked like at the time. But as I say, I never seen it actually finished, but I could see it out late.
And did they have a sign as well?
The sign there was across the top, it read the Rose and Crown. Yeah. It was on a board sort of thing, you know. But funny, isn't it?
What did you think about that? It must have felt quite strange to see that there.
Well, it was strange to see a lot of things there. But my guy used to say, I wish the Christ that would open it. Let me get a drink, like, you know.
So what else was strange there? What else made you feel a bit strange about it?
Well, I think what I always felt strange about, how could MD live there for a 12-month, you know, Alfred, you know, that made me think, you know, even though that was there, I wouldn't like to stop down there for 12 months.
Why?
I don't know. Didn't seem right, you know. You wouldn't see in the sky, you wouldn't have any rain, you wouldn't see sunshine. I mean, I don't know how they could live under the hill. I suppose if it was a case of having to do it, if they were going to drop a hydrogen bomb or something like that, then you wouldn't mind staying down there. But other than that, I wouldn't have liked that. That was a strange place, really.
Did you find it disturbing?
Not to me personally, because I knew I was coming up out of it every night, you know. So it didn't worry me too much that way. Sometimes it is good times, especially winter time. You get down there in the morning, it could be snowing up here on the surface. When you come up at night, it was all gone. So sometimes in the winter, you would never see it, really. So that was a good point.
You were saying about strange things. You talked about the road signs there. What kind of signs were there?
That's right. You get little round signs with the usual red and white colour with the black print in the middle, like 5 miles per hour, and crossroads, and they stop signs, and you know, that sort of thing, and they give way in different areas, you know. So that was something unusual you would think you see under there, you know.
And the electric cars, what were they like?
Well, they were just like a flatbed thing where, like bench seating, because there wasn't a hell of a lot of distance we're going to travel, so it was just a sort of back to back sort of thing, and just on and off sort of thing. That's what they generally looked like. Yeah.
And you were describing as well the vaults where the records were going to be kept. Can you describe what those rooms were like, how big they were, and what they were for?
Yeah, I suppose there would be something like they were in concrete with a steel door. They were about, I suppose, There were two or three of them, maybe 12 feet by about 12 feet by about 18 feet. I was roughly, you know, thinking back, that's off the top of my head. I think there were about three of them there at that particular area that I'd seen then.
Mm-hmm. Did you keep in touch with anyone after you left who was still working there?
No, we didn't keep in touch with them after I left there. There's a lot of the local people work there, so I'm in touch with them, a lot of them still today.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, I know a lot of the guys that worked under there who worked locally and live locally.
And what happened to it then after you left? Was it used in the 1970s and 80s?
It was never used as to what it was supposed to be used for, and thank God for that. But what they'd done then, I think the MOD had mentioned defence. They had probably a skeleton staff which kept the place ticking over, like running machinery and what have you, periodically to keep it in working order. And I believe it's still the same today. It's still there today. Well, at this time, it could be obsolete now, that sort of thing. I don't know. It was such a long while ago.
Do you think it was right to create a place like that? Because millions of people would have died in a nuclear war, but then a handful would have survived. Was it right?
Well, my personal opinion is no. I don't think it was right. No, I think it's wrong that there's a selection of people should be saved and the rest can die, if you like to put it that way. But that wasn't the only recent government seat in the country, mind. There's others for, and where I wouldn't know where they are, but I know there were others. There's other quarries in the area.
But you were building something for your superiors to survive in, and in a war that you wouldn't have survived.
That's exactly right. That's what it all boils down to. Yeah, that's right.
Did you and the others talk about that? I mean, what did you make of it?
Yeah, well, the discussion used to be in the local clubs and pubs and that. If anything did happen, we'd be there before them.
Because you knew where it was.
We knew where it was, and we were going to damn make sure we were going to get there. Yeah, that was a. Not, that used to be the general discussion in the earlier days, yeah. There was no chance.
Yeah, thanks very much. Thank you. We'll just stop for a moment.
The question would be really nice to get the answers in the key nouns in at the start of the the questions.
Yes.
I think three in particular can say. I mean, you knew it as what, Spring Quarry? Say wrong. That's what did you call when you worked there? Did you call it Spring Quarry?
It was called Spring Quarry.
The word pub.
Oh, yeah. So it's in Derosian Crown.
That's right. Just try.
So if we try those questions again, but each time you mention, you know, Spring Quarry, and then the pub, and then the electric cars. So that way, when we have it in the report, your answer is on its own, and you refer to the.
Okay.
Let's try that.
Yeah.
Anything else? Just those three. Yeah? I was quite happy with a bit at the end and stuff like that. Could you describe the air filters for the quarry? How big were they? What were they for? And what were they called?
Well, first of all, to get the air down the shaft from the surface, at the top of one of the shafts, they used what they called Venturi tubes. And that was roughly about 90 feet up from the bottom to the surface. We fitted them Venturi tubes in. If you can imagine the old house master's voice, dog and funnel sort of thing, they were like that, but they were straight. From a small end to the circumference got wider as it came along. Well, the air come down then, straight down the shaft. And if there were any radioactive particles in that coming down, any fallout, came down there, it came through to the a large fan, what they called the Queen Mary, which blew the air up into ductants, went through an electronic device with 11,000 volts running through it, all in strands. That then took the air radio active particles out in the rest of the air went through a refrigerator and then into the ductants. So that was blowing up then through, and as it came out into the quarry through diffusers and louvers, it was fresh air.
Right. Could I ask you the same question, and perhaps you could say it in a slightly shorter answer, just in very general terms, not too much detail, but just if I was to say, how was the air controlled in the quarry, and how big was the system, and what was it called?
We've had the Venturi bit, because people wouldn't know what that was.
Yeah.
Well, the air control was only controlled by the fan, because it came down on its own from the top, and it was controlled by the fan, who then the fan blew the air through to the radioactive, to get the radioactive particles out there through the electronic device. Then it went through the refrigerator, and it was then carried on up through all the ducts, which then it went up through what they call diffusers into the different parts of the quarry.
Right. Okay. Can I just go back then to the other questions, and if in each answer you refer to Spring Quarry and then to the pub and the electric cars. So firstly, what was the how big was the Spring Quarry site? How many people worked there, and what was it being used for?
Well, Spring Quarry, when I first went down there, as I said earlier, 1957 to 61, it was I think there must have been somewhere about a total of over 200, probably 250 people worked in Spring Quarry at that time. And it was common knowledge what the contract was all about. It was what they called at that time a regional government seat. And it was going to be used for the cream of the country. They would come down under there if there were any action in regard to a hydrogen bomb.
Once again, without being...
as you said, yes.
Said earlier,
well, one more time, is that okay? Without the, as I said earlier. If I could ask you that again. So I just want to ask the same question again. How big was the site at Spring Quarry that you were working on? How many people were there? And what was it being built for?
Well, Spring Quarry, when I was there, there was approximately 250 employed there between the main contractor and the subcontractors. And it was built for the regional government seat, for the people from Whitehall, etc.
And you all knew what it was for?
And we all knew what it was for. It was common knowledge locally, and discussed in the local clubs and pubs and shops.
What did people say about it then?
Well, the comments that you used to get was, if anything happened, we'd be there before them. That was the general discussions and topics in the pubs and clubs.
Right. You talked before about a pub underground. Could you describe what the pub looked like, what it was called, and where it was?
Well, the pub, as we called it then, and the name that they gave it was the Rose and Crown. It was in the bottom end of the quarry, near the XX to the lift. It was like if you're walking along the main road in a city, you could just open the door and walk in off the pavement. It was that sort of area. It had a large front opening, like a large window. And I didn't see the finished product, but the bar area was at the rear. And the board on along the top said the Rose and Crown. And that's the last I can remember of it.
You also talked about the electric cars. How did they work, and why did they have them? How did they work in connection with the road signs and the traffic system?
Well, the electric cars was just like any other car, if you can imagine, in a city. travelling along the roads, if you came through a sign that says halt, you halt, and they gave a speed limit of 5 miles an hour. There was never any exit on that. There was a crossroad signs and stop. That was the ones I can remember. The electric trucks were like back-to-back bench seat. So you hopped on and hopped off. It was as simple as that.
Okay, thank you. I'll just check with the, yeah.
Okay.
Yes, very good. Yep. Thank you very much.
Okay. Dave, we're in PO1 here.
Yeah.
And we went down that lift there. And that took us underground there to Spring Quarry.
Yeah. And did you always go in and out through that shaft?
Yes, we always went down there and come back up that way.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. What was your normal working day down there? How long did you work?
Well, we used to go down somewhere around about half, and normally we'd work till 7 at night. We'd work overtime. Mm-hmm. That was to push the job on, obviously. There was always a deadline in these contracts. So we would work till 7, and that was 5 days a week, and we used to work 4 hours on a Saturday morning.
So which area here did you mainly work in when you went down that shaft? Which bit were you working? Was it over here?
That's right, yeah, right over here, yeah, right over in this area here, which was a PS area, what's offices.
Yeah.
We were underground, them offices are actually on there.
See?
Yeah. Probably right about here, wasn't
up there.
It? Yeah.
Yeah.
That's where the Rose and Crown, where you come down the main road, like, you know.
Yeah.
Was it near to PO2?
That's right.
Yes. Did it have pavements and...
No pavements. I was just trying to sort of illustrate how you would see a pub on the main road to give me an idea, walk straight into it, as if it was you were walking along the pavement, you walk straight into the pub, like, you know.
Yeah.
No pavement, you're walking straight off the road surface.
So then further down was the bakery and the laundry were down here?
That's right, yeah. That's right, mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah.
And the phone exchange was
in that area.
Yeah. And the living quarters?
Living quarters were back up by the.
Just to recap again, the cabinet office was around here. Where was the cabinet office and the records?
I would have thought there'd be somewhere about here.
Mm-hmm.
That area.
Yeah. And how about the government departments, all their offices, where were they?
Well, they didn't have any. The only ones I thought were just in away from PO1 where you come in.
Mm.
There was the Chiverside offices there in that area, but I'd never seen any sort of government offices under there.
Right.
Because the
was this road, was there lots of traffic on it?
No, there wasn't a lot of traffic. You know, obviously, there were more traffic when the builders were getting up and down with their sort of electric dumpers and that.
Mm.
I would just say, I suppose.
How about the.
Probably as wide as that road.
Show us again where the living quarters were.
Well, I would have thought they were up in this area, the living quarters,
mm-hmm.
if I remember right. Yeah, and definitely up that way, yeah.
And the cabinet office and the records?
I thought we were down about this area here, in the machine shop area.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure there were three in there somewhere, this side of the main road.
Right.
Yeah, I'm sure of that.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, carry on.
Not quite
that. Not away. I was going to say, you can sit slightly closer towards just the eye line, slightly straight.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah,
there
you go. That's like right. That. Yeah, that's better. That's great. Just a bit more, just like change the shot.
very striking one, in fact, for the railway tunnel.
The entrance.
It doesn't matter. It's all part of the architecture.
So.
We went in yesterday, just go down to that entrance. Okay?
Yeah.
Is it on the right here?
Yeah.
Ah. What?
So we can't really go down the whole way then.
Go
around the car park.
No, you can't go in this area, so you're going to have to do a U-turn.
Right. Well, I think we're probably restricted from going down that road that goes through the fence.
I would have thought so.
So.
Do you want me to do some shot as we go past out the window?
Well, I'll pull up outside and we'll just do a. We actually got a school party here. Or is it a...
No, it's
more
military.
Yeah. So, just pull over here, I think, and just go and...
You wouldn't get stuck on the road, you're going to get stuck. I'll keep some wheels on the...
Alright, okay. Okay. I'll get the tractor.
This is caution. Can over from there.
You don't
okay.
Do it?
I'll do it from here. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll walk along. You're gonna follow me along. Keep this rowing. Keep rowing.
Yeah, I am rowing. But
from here.
Okay. Spin round this. So you got your back. So you don't want to be coming that way. I want to be coming that way. I've got to be that way.
This is Corsham Computer Centre, the government's new nuclear command centre. It's about half a mile from Burlington and it's part of the same complex of quarries. It's also something that Parliament has never heard of. It's part of a communications network costing hundreds of millions of pounds. And here it is, just off the main road in the Wiltshire countryside.
There we are, Pete. Don't move. Okay, start talking.
This is the Corsham Computer Centre, the government's new nuclear command centre. It's about half a mile from Burlington and part of the same complex of quarries. It's also part of a communications network worth hundreds of millions of pounds, and Parliament doesn't know about it. But here it is, just tucked away in the Wiltshire countryside.
Hello, we're from Channel 4. We just want to check this is the Corsham Computer Centre. And I'm wondering if it's okay to come and film just down here at the entrance.
No, it's not. And this is Navy Administration.
Ah, we heard this was the command centre for the government's nuclear bunker. Is that right?
Public land.
walk to the car.
Yep.
Just walk to the car, Duncan.